28-26, each team with four touchdowns. Philly has missed a couple of PATs. They trail by two. Brent Stover, the Hall of Famer, Seth Bonner. Dennis Avrilla, I mean, the offense seems to be clicking, but he's only completed four passes. Three of those complete, yeah, the big one, but three of those completions for a combined 18 yards, yet here he is up by two.
They're up by two because he's able to escape the pocket. When things break down, he's able to do something. And a lot of guys can't make these type of plays. He's able to stay pretty with his legs in an ugly game with his arm right now. Not doing a great job finding his receivers. Still learning the offense. See the big hit there, but there's the first touchdown. He's able to power his way in. And again, the step in and reverse pivot, come back around the other side and almost take this one in as well. He's done a really nice job using his leg, and that's his last score. He's using his legs, and he's going to open up some more things for him later on doing that.
Darius Reynolds for Philadelphia, six catches, 71 yards and a touchdown.
Well, Clint said he liked his ability to run with power after the catch. So you're going to see some hot routes, some quicks, getting the ball in his hands. He's able to do that. He's physical enough when he gets the ball in his hands. He's able to punish defenders. He's not just a guy that's going to run out of bounds. See the hot route there, and he's able to get upfield. Takes a big shot, but gets up and keeps on ticking. He's a fighter in the red zone as well. And this catch right here, man, just goes up and takes it. Knows he's going to get punished over the wall. I mean, he pays for it, but he wants it.
Right about put it in a good spot. Right about 13 of 18, 123, three scores. And Tina is standing by with Coach Dalzell.
All right, Brent, thank you. Coach, what do you want to see more of here in the second half, just down by two?
We just got to go out and play. We didn't play very well in the first half. We played with no energy. We finally got a little bit going there with our defense, got to stop there. So hopefully we'll play with that same in the second half.
What did you tell your players at halftime?
Pick it up. You know, we just came out flat, and that can't happen. They're too good of a football team, and that's just not us. Hopefully we'll play better in the second half.
All right, Coach, thank you. Brent?
Okay, Tina, so 28-26, and there's the Red Rocket, Radabaugh. He's gotten four receptions from Kalanamoku, three catches by McDaniel. Each of his receivers, Reynolds, Kalanamoku, and McDaniel, have a touchdown. Sims, their 18, you saw, committed a penalty, taking his helmet off before halftime. So that'll be assessed after this kickoff. Philly won the toss. They deferred, so they get it first here. Total yards 84, Cleveland 139 for Philadelphia.
Now, Chris Duvall's averaging 22 yards of return here. You're Cleveland, you got to make sure you're disciplined, stay in your lanes, make a tackle. I feel like one of these guys is going to break it.
Off the bar, picked up by Larico Stevenson, who takes it out near the 9-yard line. So not a bad job there, considering it was a good barbell by
the
Trevino.
The unsportsmanlike foul against Cleveland from the previous half will now be assessed 10 yards, first down.
So that's the 10-yard penalty again, unsportsmanlike play at the end of the half. And Quentin Sims on special teams for the Gladiators. Wells Fargo Center, Philadelphia. Road whites for Cleveland, home gray for Philly. 2-point game as we start this third quarter. Cleveland came in 1-2, and Philadelphia 2-1.
Cleveland looks like they want a little get back from that week one thrashing.
They got beat 69-41 in the opener against their rivals, the Soul. SK in motion. Radabaugh finds Sean Kalanamoku, and there he is breaking a tackle. Inside the 15, reversing field and cut down at the 13.
Didn't gain much more yards, but he bounced off the wall after the tackle. And if you're in contact with somebody and you hit the wall, it's dead. That's a good job of fighting through. But right here, that contact Lynn sent him into the wall. He picked up just six more yards, but you gotta allow him. That's a great block by Reynolds right there. Anytime these DBs are taking shots, but anytime you get a shot out in the field, you want to get something.
So Kalanamoku split wide right this time. Reynolds in motion. Radabaugh looking for Reynolds. End zone, touchdown. How about that start for the Philadelphia offense in the second half?
Great start, and Dan pops up and looks to his left like he's going to give up the quick route or the hot route. Watch him with the quick pump. That buys him a little time and knows he could float it up, knowing that backside corner is going to crash down on his receiver. Lays it up there. Darius Reynolds, too big, too strong, goes up and gets it.
Seventh catch for Reynolds, 84 yards, two touchdowns. Now Clark to make it a 5-point game. Missed wide left. He's missed three PATs now. It remains 32-28 Philly. 2 minutes deep, third quarter. Philly with a lot to celebrate as they start on fire offensively in the third quarter here at home today. Coming up next, we have men's college lacrosse. The Virginia Cavaliers take on the Georgetown Hoyas from the multi-sport field in Washington, D.C. Ben Holden and Evan Washburn will call the action as soon as we're done here on CBS Sports Network.
Big Ben Holden.
Yeah, kind of love it. And former Delaware star defenseman Washburn. Senior tagman James Pinnell, his older brother Rob Pinnell, one of the great college players of all time at Cornell, now doing it in the Major League Lacrosse. Good numbers for James this season. Good numbers tonight and all season for Darius Reynolds. Just caught his second touchdown pass.
Primarily a Eastern type game, lacrosse. It's sweeping the nation. It's huge in Colorado where I live, and DU's one of the top programs in the nation, and it's sliding on the West Coast as well. So
absolutely.
It's trending.
Larry Beavers. He had some electrifying returns, and he had another one going. Slipped and fell, rolled, got back up, and is still somehow able to take it into Philadelphia territory.
This was the one. I just said one of these guys is going to break it, and there he is at the 11-yard line with its first tackle solo on the game.
I love that he rolled over and just kept on going. 31-yard return.
I mean, he has a different type of speed level to his game, and that's something that Cleveland hasn't had. Teron Liu is a fast guy, but he's a long strider. This dude Beavers is quick and fast.
Ball security used to be an issue for him, but hasn't been this season. Paprilla from midfield, all kinds of time, rifles it incomplete, looking for Beavers down inside the 5-yard line.
It's good defense staying at home. Played combo on the outside, allowed the motion man to run to the post, and then he goes back to the corner where he had Belton waiting for him. There's a post and a corner combo with a dig underneath that did not win. That's good coverage, not really anywhere for Villa to go with the football.
So second down from midfield. With Theron Lewis has been quiet, going in motion for Cleveland. Avrilla near side, Taylor fell. Belton was thinking pick six.
He almost tipped it up, reaching back, trying to catch it. Well, the Gladiators might need to check their spikes and their cleats. We're in turf fields. We've had some guys hit the deck here. You're a QB going back and you're throwing a timing round. You watch a guy fall as you're letting it go.
At least you got a built-in excuse.
That's where you want that. You want to get it back.
Cleveland 1-for-3 on third down today.
It's 31% on the season.
Yeah. Taylor only 2 catches for 5 yards. He's in motion.
False start.
And they blow it dead on the false start.
Before the snap, false start, 44 offense. It's a 5-yard penalty, third down.
It's Manley.
See him jump right there, and it's hard to stop it when you get it moving. Philly doing a nice job of mixing guys in. They're trying to get Richard Kleberg some more touches.
7th penalty, 41 yards in Cleveland. Brings up 3rd and 15 from their own 20.
We got Jake Metz at the Mac linebacker spot. Justin Lawrence, this should be a good group to get pushed with.
And they don't get the playoff.
Delay, offense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
I mean, it's been.
But that was a quick one. I don't know how that. I don't know how that happened. That was pretty quick. That was fairly quick. Literally, the penalty just happened. And
I can't argue with you. 3rd and 20. 5 minutes into the third, Philadelphia leads by 4. Lewis, the motion man. Habrilla steps up, launches, end zone. Lewis, touchdown, Cleveland on 3rd and 20. They convert a 35-yard score.
And this is all the legs. All the legs of Dennis Habrilla. You see him split the pocket, get up inside, and that's a good pass rush. That took a long time, and as a secondary player, you can't cover that long. You want to try and stay attached, but when a guy's hitting you with a couple double moves, it's hard to stay attached.
Especially.
But a well-thrown ball on the move.
Longest completion of the game, 35-yard touchdown strike, Trevino the PAT. Especially in the Arena League, especially when the guy went in motion, got that running start. Lewis converts it. Cleveland back on top. If you want access to every AFL game at once, go to arenafootball.com, click AFL Live for the online broadcast of the games around the league. Said you got a decision to make. The Rattlers coming up after our game on AFL Live. But you and I might check out Chicken Pizza after the game, right, for the Philadelphia postgame party. So what, are you going to be carrying the phone around and watching?
No, man, they got TVs.
Oh, that, yeah.
Come on, man. Hopefully they're
going to pull up the
smart TVs.
Okay.
Right?
I like the way you're thinking.
They got smart TVs, so hopefully they do that.
You and I will be in Arizona next weekend for the Steel and the Rattlers. Rattlers are 3-0.
Tough one on the road in Jacksonville tonight.
Trevino sends it away. Duvall with his back against the back wall. Cut down. Beautiful. Arvell Nelson as he falls across the 5-yard line. And Tina down below with Theron Lewis.
Yes, Brent. Thank you. Theron, 3rd and 20. What was the discussion in the huddle before that play?
Nothing. Execute. You're going to throw it, I'm going to go get it.
One of the beauties of the Arena Football League is the motion before the snap. So how is that just beneficial in a situation like that?
I mean, with me just knowing that I am a speedster, you know, as far as a fast guy, honestly, I don't need a motion, but I mean, it does help out to get that, you know, that edge and that little step on the DB, because I mean, he's backpedaling for 10 to 15 yards, so it helps out.
Theron, thank you.
Thank you.
Brent?
And again, Tina, that hot read there to Darius Reynolds gets him a first down after the 19.
He is punishing dudes. He's looking like Walter Payton with the ball in his hands.
He's a pretty big guy.
He's thick. He's a lot thicker through the leg and hip area than people think. And I think when they come to tackle him, they don't expect him to be as strong as he is.
And a nice college career at Iowa State, now 5th season in the AFL. 2 lead changes. At one point, Cleveland led 28-13. It's been back and forth since. Radapa, his team down 3. Reynolds far boards, delivers more punishment this time to Brandon Stevens, and he's able to push forward for another first.
They got to be tired of seeing him, but they run motion to the front side. Take a look at this, or listen to this. I mean, that looks like an Ike tailback.
You got it.
Straight 3 on the coverage. Dan just taking what they're giving him. This is a rage formation, far right, far left.
McDaniel in motion, rifled near side. SK the catch down to the 12.
And again, Clint and Dan just being patient, trying to force Cleveland to play a little man-to-man. Seeing a lot of zone coverage between the 10s. They're trying to wait till they get into the Geico blue zone to start playing man coverage. I'm talking about the Gladiators defense, but they're giving up way too big of chunks on easy pitches and catch.
Helena Moku, 6 receptions, 67 yards. Flipped out to McDaniel, trying to get that edge. Lunges forward near the 5. Marvin Ross on the tackle. To bring up a 1st and goal, move the sticks again for the Soul.
It's a great job by Ryan McDaniel. He gets around and on the quick screen, fights through the leg leg tackle and gets there. And watch Tribune. You got to be careful there. He almost got himself a personal foul. But the effort from McDaniel, talking about him earlier, he was kind of quiet till the end of that first half. You've got to find ways to get him touches. He is a guy that wants to get it done and works extremely hard to do so.
And Ken Reynolds, touchdown. Terrius Reynolds, for the third time today, finds the end zone.
Again, physicality. Physicality. Good blocking out front. It's just a screen. Arvell Nelson gets a good shot on him, but he just bounces off. I mean, that's a good hit by Arvell Nelson. And he just bounces off, walks in the end zone, and makes that young man's day.
And gave him respect as well. He wants the contact. And this time, Clark able to knock it through. 39-35 on this touchdown by Reynolds, his third. Five trips into the red zone for Philly today. They've scored touchdowns on all five. Third quarter, Philly back on top. That young fan is having a perfect afternoon. Look at what just transpired here.
Perfect quarter. Watch the hands catch. Oh, that's awesome. Great hands catch. We got a football. We're being recorded. Oh, then. Oh, man, you didn't give me. But look at this kid. This young, nice man just gave up the hot dog. That's a pretty good third quarter.
It's a pretty good back-to-back.
Best third quarter in the building, I think, so far.
Terrius Reynolds gives the young fan a football, and then the nice little kid that catches the hot dog and then gives it away. That
he's like, oh, I got 10 others. I'm good. I got 10 today.
Reynolds' third touchdown, onside kick. Sims goes up and packs it about seven rows deep.
You can't bat the ball.
Well, they let him do it that time. Clearly it was Sims doing everything he could to get that thing out of play. And evidently no harm, no foul, and it works out. So Philadelphia trying to again use that element of surprise with Clark, but Cleveland able to get possession and now inside the 20 of the Soul. Haverill near side, Lewis. And it's incomplete. And Tina is with Darius Reynolds.
Darius, what has been different about the offense since you guys came out in the third quarter?
We kind of shot ourselves in the foot the first half. We kind of started a little slow. We had a turnover. We got to eliminate that. Our intensity's picked up since halftime. Coach kind of got on us. We were a little down the first half. So mostly it's just intensity and having that fire and knowing that we can't be stopped.
How do you describe the chemistry between you and Dan Radabaugh today?
I mean, since I even talked about signing with him, he's contacted me. He's told me how excited he was to have me, and he's been nothing but great since I've been out here. So we've just been working hard to get our time and the connection down.
All right, Brent, to you.
Joe Goosby will put Reynolds and the offense back out there on the interception and four-yard return as Haverilla threw it right to Joe Goosby.
He wants to go to Colin in your living room, but the jack runs all the way to the wall. Joe Goosby is sitting there. He never accounts for the jack linebacker. They had him covered. He should have thrown this ball to Colin Taylor on the post route. There's nobody in that back right corner of the end zone. That ball should have gone there, and he is a little bit banged up as he's limping off the field right now, and Arvell Nelson is now on the field warming up. He took a shot low and late. You hate to see that, but
there's Nelson, the jack linebacker, is also the backup quarterback, and quickly getting loose with that right arm.
Well, they'll throw Joe Finnessy back in there at the jack position. The guy was a turnover machine in their Arena Bowl run a couple years ago, playing the jack spot. So Arvell will get in and get ready to play some quarterback. And he's a guy with exceptional skill sets, whether running with his feet or throwing the football.
So Philly back on offense from the 19. Dan Radabaugh rifles it, caught Kalanamoku down in inside the Gladiator 5.
Let him get in rhythm, and this is a great job of pass pro up front. The bigs are doing a great job. Wayne Tribue, Adam Smith, and Neil Tivis. Watch the protection for Dan. He's able to get back and settle and really step into it. Throws a laser on the deep post route that he flattens out.
26-yard completion. And now 16 Philly first downs, only 6 for Cleveland. Yet it's a 4-point game and wide open. Richardson put out of nowhere an open field tackle by DeMarcus Robinson.
Well, I think Jeremy needs to cut inside of that. Don't try to go around. Cut right inside. Put the onus on him to try and square you up. You go around right there. Just cut. Plant your right foot in the dirt. Don't try to avoid. Put your right foot in the turf and get upfield and try and get through him. That's a really good tackle by D-Rock.
Seventh year man from Henderson State. Second down goal from the 2. Reynolds in motion. Handoff right side again, and this time barreling into the end zone is Richardson for the sole touchdown.
And he would not be denied on that one. You see him plant the right foot and just pound it in inside. He knows he missed an opportunity, but gets another chance. Clint gives it back to him right there. Great footwork. A plant to get up inside. Huge play from Joe Goosby on the defensive side. Turns into points. And this is what Philly thought they'd be doing. They've come out in the second half and done an outstanding job.
Extra point good. 46-35. Cleveland at one point led 28-13. They've been outscored 33-7 since. Goosby the interception, then Richardson pays it off. 11-point sole advantage. Third quarter, sole up by 11. Again, on a 33-7 run in this game. Richardson, 5 carries, 10 yards, 2 touchdowns, including that one moments ago. And you look at what he can do on both sides of the ball.
Very versatile, old school throwback. You know, having that kind of season, if he continues on, he'll be up around the tops in the league in rushing.
That drive, 3 plays, 31 yards, and a minute 40. Richardson's second score. And the sole lead, 46-35. Pat Clark sends it away. Beavers takes it off the net. Larry Beavers across the 10. Chopped down at the 14. See who comes out. Quarterback, it'll be Arvell Nelson. Starting Jack, he's the backup quarterback, and he's going to start this drive. It's a hyper-extended knee. Tina Servasio down on the sideline for us. He is reporting it's a hyper-extended knee for Havrilla on his last play on the field.
See, he's waiting, he's stepping in, and right there, the leg, right there on the leg whip. It's kind of a roll. You're taught if you're on the ground as a defensive player, keep rolling towards the quarterback.
Yeah.
It's just one of those things. And he just caught his leg locked.
Arvell Nelson, backup quarterback, is 0 for 4 this season. Going to tuck it and run on his first chance. And a big run into Philadelphia territory is Arvell Nelson. And a gain of 14 on his first touch offensively.
Again, Jake Metz, and this guy never stops. Runs the hoop upfield and gets back into play. But there was an opportunity on that play for Larry Beavers. Arvell Nelson misses him, not comfortable with the throw, and then takes off, picks up a nice gainer on the first down.
Arvell Nelson, 6'5", 225. Fourth-year man from Texas Southern. Pitches, throws, 3 rows deep, with coverage by Belton, looking for Taylor near boards.
We wanted the sailing route with Beavers in the middle of the field. Joe Goosby took that throw away. And he's just got to settle in and get into playing the quarterback spot. It's hard when you've been playing Jack with a different type of mindset. Now you got to go out and kind of refocus, reshuffle the things in your mind and kind of figure out what you need to do to be successful.
15 seconds left, third quarter. Nelson, back of quarterback, quick hitter, Taylor. A strike that time. And down to the 17-yard line is Colin Taylor. That's the final play of this third quarter.
Into the third quarter.
So Cleveland with Nelson now in a quarterback trying to put together a drive as Philadelphia has dominated the second half. End of three. The Soul 46, the Gladiators 35. You're watching the Arena Football League on CBS Sports Network. Back in Philadelphia, home of Rocky. Beautiful day outside. We're inside Wells Fargo Center. The Philadelphia Flyers will play inside here tomorrow afternoon, trying to keep their series alive in the opening round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Philly outscored Cleveland 20-7 in the third. They lead by 11, trying to get to 3-1 on the season.
This team executes at a high level. It's a pretty thing to watch.
He says they're better, Dalzell, than last year, and they went 15-3 last year and set the franchise record. Nelson, the backup quarterback. Starter Dennis Havrilla out with a hyperextended knee. As we begin the fourth, Nelson guns it behind the receiver. Theron Lewis streaking toward the goal line.
That's where he might have to have a little touch on this ball, but Lewis doesn't get his head around. It's on his back shoulder. That's a really tough catch. However, did you see that rifle shot he threw there? Man, more anticipation. With a little more touch, and that's an easy walk-in touchdown.
Fourth down and four, key play. Philadelphia's got all the momentum. Cleveland at one point led 28-13. Now they're down 11. Fourth and four, lofts it up, end zone. Touchdown, Quentin Sims. And there's some touch from Arvell Nelson.
This is all off the release. Quentin's still talking. Special teams, catch the touchdowns. He's going to let you know about it, but this is a great release by him. Slips inside, and you can't give up that inside if you're James Romaine, and I think he got caught looking in the backfield. Sims hasn't caught any balls, so you're looking at another receiver. You're looking at Colin Taylor to probably be the guy to beat you. Gives you the slip for the easy touchdown.
They're going to go for two. Theron Lewis in motion. Nelson looking for Lewis, back of the end zone, he caught it. Up against the back wall, a two-point conversion for Cleveland, and it is 46-43. Nelson, Lewis, giving up his body for the 2 points, and it's 46-43. Back in Philly, 13:25 to play. It's a three-point Soul lead, but Cleveland regaining some of the momentum with a touchdown and a two-point conversion. And it's been about exactly what we expected in terms of the competitiveness between these two sides. As Trevino going to tee it up at the Geico goal line to send this one away.
I'm sure the Philly fans weren't expecting it after the thrashing they put on the Gladiators in week one.
The 43 points by Cleveland is a season high.
What, you know, they've had pick sixes all year. Their secondary's played outstanding all year. They've had some communication issues in this game, but they've been really good.
They're going to blow it dead here. Coach is out on the field, going to not sure what, not coach, but one of the workers here inside the building. Having trouble with that. I'm not sure what the situation is in that far corner. You don't want to speculate, but it looks. Looks like it could be something serious here.
It is.
It's Steve Tunn. Looks like they're taking Tunn back up the tunnel. We'll be back to explain it after this. Moments ago, Steve Tunn, head coach for Cleveland. Some sort of a medical situation. They took him up the tunnel. Tina has more.
Well, Brent, yes, he is being tended to right now by the team doctors. EMT obviously is on hand. He is back in the Gladiators locker room. It was interesting. I was going to look for him for an interview, and I couldn't find him. And I kept looking for him. And what it was, his assistant coaches didn't even realize he was not in the box at the bench. And that's when they ran onto the field, and they started blowing on, you know, calling the timeout. He was in the end zone by the boards. He sort of made his way for special teams to call the play from the field, and then he asked for emergency crew. Back to you.
All right, Tina, thanks. So, Coach Tunn back in the locker room. This one loose. Philly able to pick it up with LaGrico Stevenson and is immediately hit at the two. So, obviously, this takes on a little bit of a different tone, concern. Well, now here he is coming back out. So, there's Steve Tunn, and he's back on the field.
And listen, if he's not out there, what's tough about the situation is Chris Deeker not being, it's a road game, Chris Deeker not here. Who would call the plays if he wasn't able to get out there and do it offensively? Backup QB in there, be a tough situation. I just hope Coach Tunn is all right.
From the three, Tanner Onopah. Now 8 of 8 here in this second half. And he has been on fire that time. Connects with Kalena Moku for the first down pickup.
Taking what the defense gives you, being patient. You see a high zone, field corner way off and inside. You want to get that ball out as fast as possible. He does a nice job of reading it out. And he's seen just about everything. The way you're going to get to him is by getting pressure and changing what he's looking at.
Reynolds got crushed as he went out. Marker down, pass complete out to the 20, and Reynolds is still down to the 22. And now there's some talking at the other 20-yard line.
That's definitely a finable offense. That's terrible. You got to have your head on a swivel. However, I mean, he just launches into him.
It was that hot read route that they've been looking at all day.
Well,
right?
They weren't throwing it. He's coming in motion, running full tilt.
Audible looked him off that time, and defender absolutely blew him up around that 20-yard line. Now some fans throwing drinks on the field. That making a bad situation worse. They're able to get Reynolds up, so that's good. Now we'll see. You know what the call is. Here's another look.
It's going to be a defenseless receiver. He's running in motion. And, I mean, he launches shoulders above the. I mean, the question is, do you leave him on the field? Not Reynolds.
DeMarcus Robinson.
D-Rob, do you leave him on the field, or is he going to be ejected from the game? Because he's most likely going to be suspended.
They're already down Joel Powell.
It's a personal foul, unnecessary roughness, blindside hit, number 3, defense. He has disqualified himself for the remainder of the game. Wow. First down.
So he's out. They're already down Powell. And now they're going to be
Listen, he's a defenseless receiver. They've caught him on the hot route. You can't just launch into a guy. I mean, for the safety of the game, you can't do that. Yeah. You can't just launch your body into a guy.
So he's been disqualified. Arvell Nelson, your starting jack, is now playing quarterback for Cleveland. Joel Powell, for the second week in a row, can't play a defensive back. He's injured. So it's Finnessy, Ross, and Stevens. And now Colin Taylor, the wide receiver, will come in to play jack for Cleveland. Wow. They are down on numbers defensively. Over the middle, wide open receiver McDaniel. Hit and dropped, helmet flies off at the Cleveland 12.
That was his own guy. That was Wayne Tribute following up the play, just hustling. Watch 96 come into play right there. That's his own guy inflicting pain.
All right, Tina has another update on Coach Tun.
So, Brent, as I reported earlier in the game, Coach Tun has been experiencing heart problems. He was taken to a hospital before a game 2 weeks ago, and that is why when he said he didn't feel good, he actually put his head down on the boards, on the padding. Immediately, team doctors took him away and checked him, but they cleared him to go back on the field, Brent.
Okay, Tina, thanks. So, obviously, good news there as Richardson takes it forward for a gain of a couple.
And with a new jack in the game, Arvell Nelson, the starting jack linebacker, you get a new jack in the game. And Colin Taylor, now you're going to try and take advantage of that in the running game, the screen game, and those kind of things, and see if he's up to par on his calls and what he's supposed to be doing.
Another dust up after.
After the play and after the first down has been reached, it's unsportsmanlike conduct, 3 of the offense, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Okay, so that's Richardson after his carry. Back to the 18.
Listen, it's a highly emotional game, especially after a hit like that. You definitely want to take up for your brothers. You definitely want to take up for your brothers and be there for your brothers. But winning this game is what's most important, not giving up free plays or hurting your team.
First and 10. Back to the 18. Ronabaugh floats it up. Running under it for the touchdown catch is Ryan McDaniel. And now he's going to get a marker for spiking it right at the feet of the Cleveland defender. I mean, come on.
I don't know about this. But
the touchdown's good. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, 19 of the offense, spiking the ball towards an opponent. It's a 10-yard penalty, will be assessed first play after the kickoff.
Said I thought he was seeking him out. Honestly, it looked like it. Now,
well, that's because there was a little late jostle, but a good speed release inside. You don't get any help from your jack, you got no chance. Look at the loft on that ball, and right there, because of the
toss down,
the late toss down, he turns around and spikes it close enough to draw the ire of the official.
Did you say something on the top about bad blood between these two?
Yes.
That's what I thought. Pat Clark, good. Extra point.
You want to know how to throw a ball over the top and drop it in the bucket. Look at that. Quick throw up and down in a short area. But right there, the throw down with the split, with the strip. And come here. I just beat you for a touchdown. I'm going to spike in the face now.
You seem to be okay with the spike.
Listen, I don't like penalties anyway. When they're silly ones. But you didn't take points off the board right there.
It's true.
As an offensive player.
They will lose yardage depending on what happens on the kickoff here. I mean, either way, whatever happens, it'll get marked off after the return.
I'd rather get it out there. Get the frustration out of his system there than to go down on the next kickoff or something like that and really hurt his team.
The lead is 10 for Philadelphia with 10:29 to play. McDaniel with his first touchdown catch of the day. And again, Cleveland, their starting jack, Arvell Nelson, is now in at quarterback because of an injury to the starter, Dennis Avrilla. And now Colin Taylor, the star receiver, is the jack right now on defense for Cleveland. And they've got DeMarcus Robinson was just ejected from the game. Beg your pardon, that's McDaniel. McDaniel's second touchdown catch of the game. So he's got 2. to go with three for Darius Reynolds.
Look at Rodabaugh's numbers, though, are pretty good. 23 of 28, 245, five touchdowns, and he completed one. Actually, he's got six touchdowns because he threw one to Cleveland.
Beavers off the net. Larry Beavers cut down inside the five. To your point about Rodabaugh, second half alone, 10 of 10 for 135 and three touchdowns. And now more extracurriculars and another marker down. I mean, I don't know what at what point maybe both coaches get the teams together and say, guys, we gotta play football at some point.
The first quarter, you try to. That's what they're doing, but you can't control.
That's when play's over. Unsportsmanlike conduct, 19, Philadelphia. There's a previous foul for unsportsmanlike on 19. Only one 10-yard penalty will be assessed. First down.
Listen, that's the old Ryan McDaniels. He is an improved in his maturity, but he is feisty and competitive, and he's going at it, fighting up there on top of the screen. And that's, I mean, he must throw a punch there. It'd be the last. Yeah, see, they're not even watching. They were both going at it and fighting. But listen, he's matured a ton. This guy is as competitive as they come. But he got baited on that one.
So he picks up back-to-back personal fouls. Penalty marked off. Wide open, Taylor. Colin Taylor with a touchdown of his own, 35 yards. And back and forth we go here in the fourth quarter.
And the two Jets linebackers hooking up. Oh my goodness, what a great throw too. The ball was out early. It just shows you this guy has the ability, pumps the corner to keep him at home, but throws it out to the corner over the top. And Colin Taylor, what, can't run? A lot of people think so. Folks, this guy can run, he's strong, and has great hands. Good throw and catch.
Now Trevino. What a game. As Trevino misses. Wow, so it's 53.
Offsides, receiving team, 99. Half the distance, retry.
Retry at 53-49. He'll get another crack at it here.
I just saw Arvell Nelson spin the ball. You're supposed to turn the laces out of the way. He turned the laces all the way around in front. I can see it from here. We're way away. And you know those kickers, they don't want to see the laces. They get a little nervous. He turned the laces all the way in front of Trevino.
We get Arvell is doing about everything you can possibly
do. But you got to do the job you're responsible for right now.
See if he gets it. There you go. Trevino knocks it through on the second attempt. Hey, Nelson's 2 for 3, 51 yards and two scores at quarterback, and it's a three-point game.
It's a great dime, dropping it in the bucket. Great hands by the former Indiana Hoosier.
Monday night at 7, join us in the studio. Our panel of experts dissect the quarterback prospects in the upcoming NFL draft. Inside College Football Draft Special, presented by Stouffer's Fit Kitchen. The quarterback show, only on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Adam Schein and his QBs in the studio, looking forward to that early next week. Fourth quarter here in Philadelphia. Tina has been busy, especially in the second half. What do you have, Tina?
Well, the good news is Darius Reynolds is on the field. He is about to get in on this play. I talked to some of the training staff, and they did the concussion protocol on Reynolds, and quote, his clinicals looked great. But of course, they're going to monitor him. That was a really hard hit, but he passed everything, and he's back on the field, Brent.
Tina, thanks. So that's good news. He's back on the field. Coach Tun, who went to the locker room with a little bit of a health scare, he's back on the bench. Dennis Avril, a Cleveland starting quarterback, has reportedly got a hyperextended knee. He's out of the game right now, and it's Arvell Nelson who just threw that long touchdown throw.
He just dropped dime right in the middle of the game?
Yes.
To the other Jack linebacker?
To the other Jack linebacker, because Colin. Because of all the injuries and now, again, with DeMarcus Robinson getting kicked out of the game, Colin Taylor, who just caught the touchdown pass, is in playing the Jack linebacker on defense. filling in for Nelson, who's playing quarterback, and now an onside kick. It's loose. Philly had a chance at it, but took a fortunate Cleveland bounce and recovered by Brandon Stevens.
It was touched too early. It's touched too early here by Cleveland. You're going to see it's touched right about the 8-yard line right there. It goes off the shoulder pads of Sims.
The ball was illegally touched by Cleveland before it went 10 yards. First down.
So this turned out perfectly for Philadelphia.
Kick just didn't go far enough. But that's a good call.
And now a challenge flag.
Cleveland is challenging the call on the field.
Steve Tunn wants to take another look. And we will have an arena football call to the booth. Joe Pista, referee, will jump on headset and visit with the guys in our truck, and you will hear everything as he takes another look to review this important call late in this game with Cleveland trying an onside down 3.
The ruling on the field was Cleveland illegally touched the ball before it went 10 yards. Cleveland is challenging that Philadelphia touched the ball first. We need video evidence. Touch number 18. Okay. All right. Thank you.
Easy enough, huh?
That's about as easy as it could get right there.
So Steve Tunn loses the challenge.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. 18 for Cleveland. Touched the ball before it went 10 yards. Philadelphia's ball, first down.
Dalzell's guys get it at the Cleveland 7 now. Leading by 3 with just under 9 to play.
Cleveland has charged their first timeout.
And again there, the Gladiators lose a timeout.
It's an area where you can put some pressure offensively and really try and be physical with the receivers. But if you're going to, you got to force Philly right now into some tough plays. You got to force them to work. You can't give up a freebie. They've had trouble with this stack formation all afternoon.
Kalenamoku in motion. He catches the pass. Farboard spins off the board. Dives to the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
They just get you outflanked in so many different ways. But again, you've got two shields out in front. Kalenamoku comes down in motion and then pops out wide, and his defender is so far off that gives him space and opportunity to catch the ball. Spins off the wall, and Marvin Ross can't get back inside quick enough to make the tackle. And you got to be impressed with the yards after the catch with this entire receiving corps.
It's like a pinball off that wall. And now Clark, extra point, good. The lead is back to 10. 60-50 Philadelphia with 7:59 remaining. We've seen a little bit of everything in this game.
We have the short passing game attack.
Arvell Nelson in at quarterback, and he's standing by with Tina.
All right, Arvell, a couple of touchdown passes, 2-point conversion. Coach Thon said you didn't even fully know the whole offense yet. How were you able to adapt so quickly?
Just experience, just knowing the game. You know, even though I'm playing Jack, I still get my film study at offense. So, you know, I'm prepared. He might have said I'm not, but I'm prepared all the time.
What are you ready for now as you're ready to take the field again?
Say it again.
What are you ready for? What's the plan, the game plan, as you're ready to take the field here?
Just stay consistent. That's it. Get the ball to my guys and let them make the plays.
All right, Arvell, thank you. Brent?
Okay, Tina. Playing from behind here, down 10.
I've always liked everything about Arvell, his delivery, everything. And just hasn't been in the right spot at the right time to really take that job and run with it. But he's been so good at the jack position. You know, in 2014, he played alongside with, you know, played jack on the Pittsburgh team with a quarterback by the name of Tommy Grady, who was pretty good. I mean, so wasn't going to get on the field.
And now Clark on the kickoff.
Kick out of bounds. The ball will be placed at the 20-yard line. First down.
Sends it about seven rows deep.
You must know somebody over there, because you rarely see that one.
I've never seen.
You must know somebody over in that section.
That's a hook. All right. You talked earlier about the hook of your golf swing.
Yeah, the lefty hook gets, when it gets ugly, it can get really bad.
So this is out to the 20 for Cleveland.
First take Cleveland on the 20.
Nelson is 2 for 3. Couple of touchdown throws. Taylor in motion. Flipped out. Taylor the block. Into Philadelphia territory goes Quentin Sims.
Good hustle play and hit by Joe Goosby. Nice pickup. And Taylor with a nice block on the front side, which gives his guy some room to run. Excuse me. Picks up Tracy Belton. With Joe Goosby hustling over from the jack spot to make the tackle.
And Cleveland playing without Dominic Goodman at receiver today. Jennings jump, Taylor the catch inside the 10. As he gets drilled right there, it'll be another first down for the Gladiators.
Offside, 98 defense. That penalty's declined, resulting play, first down.
So Jennings jumping off early.
Trying to get a little jump. Tell you that your eyes kind of light up as a quarterback, but it's hard not to want to hold the ball and let somebody go deep for it because you know you got a free play.
Nelson finding his groove a little bit.
He is. He's running the offense, and that's what I'm really impressed with there. He still took his read and made the right throw.
Nelson floats it up for Lewis, and the coverage by Pelton, and he wanted offensive pass interference.
You're not going to get that 9 out of 9 times. I mean, that's all it is two guys hand fighting for position, because Belton was holding down with his left arm.
But wasn't Lewis holding his right arm down? But, he's trying to get it back around.
So there's a no call. They're both kind of holding each other. Two wrongs don't make a right, my friend. Come on.
Second down goal. From the 9, Sims in motion. Nelson steps up in trouble, and he's sacked. Back at the 15-yard line.
Welcome to Philadelphia, Richard Cleaver. Play took a little bit too long. First sack of the game for Philadelphia. But, I mean, you've got to have that clock in your head. That play took a long time. To me, that's a stand-up job by that offensive line. The receivers and quarterback have to do a better job of getting open and getting the ball out of their hand. Really good job by the guys up front.
Philly now with 8 sacks this year. Brings up a 3rd and goal from back at the 14. Nelson pumps over the middle. Comes it caught, 5-yard line. And dropped there is Lewis. Which brings up a manageable, very manageable 4th down and goal as Hollis made the tackle.
It's extremely manageable in yardage. However, you've completely shrunk the field down, and it's going to make it tough. There's going to be some hand fighting, and if you're an offensive player, you got to try to fight through it. Don't look for the penalty calls here. You haven't seen a release from the fullback or the tight end since the first quarter of this game by Cleveland. 0 coverage on the front side, not a bad time to do it.
Cleveland 2 of 3 on 4th down. Nelson with time, rolls out of the pocket, guns it, intercepted. Philadelphia, and they mark him down in the end zone. And the pick by Dwayne Hollis, his 3rd interception of the season.
You knew there was tight coverage there. It's tough. You've got to fight as a receiver to get open. But when you look at this replay, there's not a lot of separation anywhere on the field. Gray shirts in front of the white shirts all over the place. Hollis, right place, right time.
So out to the 5-yard line after the costly interception. Clock winding down to the 4-minute mark. Philly's got it back, leading by 10. Shortle shrug and a man wide open. Chris Duvall, the speedster, into the end zone. A 45-yard touchdown strike.
That's great for the average. If you're Raba and DuVault. But manipulation of the pocket and the secondary by Dan Radabaugh is what happens here. Watch the quick pump fake by Radabaugh. You get the field corner to bite down and try to go up and make a play and do someone else's job. Brandon Stevens jumps all over that flat route, and this is a well-thrown ball right over the top.
First catch of the day for DuVault, 45-yard touchdown. Extra point good, it's 67-50. Look at the second half for Dan Radabaugh. 12 of 12.
He was pretty good in the first half. Just the one INT, which went to the house, but 12 for 12, 187 and five touchdowns. That's pretty good.
Eight scores for the game. The 315 passing yards, a season high for Dan Radabaugh. And he's got his team with their largest lead now at 17.
But you see early on, what was it? Those short routes, the hot routes, the quick screens, setting them up, and all of a sudden they get Cleveland to bite on one, and they're able to bite off a huge chunk of yards. Chris DuVault is a young player that this team loves. This kid is coming on. He's doing an outstanding game job in the kicking game, but he's learning the offense and the nuances that go along with it. Really like his talent and his ability to stretch the field and run with speed.
There's a reason that at this moment, Philadelphia is your number two receiving core in the AFL. We're seeing why today. .313 remaining. Clark kicks it deep. Beavers off the net. Beavers near side, spins the other way, and he's wrapped up and ushered backwards to the two. In to clean it up was Larico Stevenson. For the latest news, scores, and stats, log on to arenafootball.com. Whether you want to check out special features on the league's brightest stars or watch live games, arenafootball.com is where it's at. There's our young fan that, in a matter of about 60 seconds, was able to get a football and a free hot dog today.
That was awesome.
Nelson from the end zone slings it out to Taylor. Taylor wrapped up and dropped at the 20. Still time here with 2:25. Got to get a score here, though.
And let's move with a sense of urgency here. Plenty of time, but let's get moving in and out of the huddle. Everybody get out and get set, and let's get rolling.
Nelson in for the injured Dennis Havrilla. Lewis in motion. Rolling out, Nelson fires it, caught. To the 19 of Philly, right around that first down marker. And indeed, move the sticks here. Beavers the catch.
Good job of taking what they give you. You're running the double cloud or the one double defense. It was actually a really good route concept with a corner from the motion man and another corner from the backside. You put a lot of pressure on that safety. The time, however, is a different issue with this pass rush starting to heat up.
Nelson from the 19. Slings it end zone over the top of Theron Lewis. And the coverage by Dwayne Hollis.
Good coverage. This is the ball again. Knowing when to put some gas on the ball and knowing when to take some off.
1 minute warning. 1 minute timing rules are now in effect.
Something Marvell Nelson will
Cleveland
learn to
has
do.
Two timeouts. Philadelphia
good valuable
has three.
Time of, on the field playing for him.
1 minute warning. 17-point Philly advantage. Dan Radabaugh has been perfect in this second half for Philadelphia.
He's manipulated the pocket and defenders with his pump fakes and ball handling. You see the ability with the quick strikes. extremely accurate when he needs to be. And I'll tell you what, when this kid gets it rolling, this is the kind of stuff you see. Lasers down the field, between coverage, makes guys pay for jumping things. When the Rocket gets it rolling, man, it's hard to stop. And this team goes as he goes. When he plays well, it's a pretty thing to watch.
Second straight game with 8 touchdown throws. The 315 yards, a season high. Meantime, Nelson with a minute to play, down 17. Second down 10. Beavers in motion. Arvell Nelson slings it end zone, intercepted. Tracy Belton over to Pickett. He's across the 15, the 20. And out to midfield, off the interception is Belton, a return of 32 yards. And Ethan, his head coach, took a spill at the end of that one.
He was trying to hang on to the wall. That's what's hilarious. Clint was jumps on top of the wall to get out of the way. Towards the end of this thing, you'll see him, Spider-Man, Tracy Belton falls off in the coverage. That's something Nelson will see as he continues to develop and get playing time. But Belton, again, baits him into the throw. But look at Clint. He's holding on for dear life up there. And Belton runs right to him. He looked like Spider-Man up there.
That was awesome.
I'm gonna give him the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man, too.
Ninth interception for the Soul this season. 2 here today. They lead the AFL in that category. Left side is trying to run that clock out now. 40 seconds. Cleveland has 2 timeouts remaining. They're just going to take this one.
It's been a little bit too crazy. I don't know if I'd probably do the same thing. It's been too crazy throughout the game. You don't need to get anybody else hurt. Few plays as possible. It's a long season. Definitely played better. Talking about Cleveland.
Clock will run out without another snap. Philadelphia wins by 17 at home. They trailed early, 28-13, and then took control for their 6th straight victory against the Gladiators. And suddenly, in the last year plus, it's been domination for the Soul. These teams meet a lot. Long season, as you mentioned, 18 games, so Cleveland will regroup, but they are 1-3 as Philly, with a 17-point win, moves to 3-1.
And they got it closer. They didn't get blown out.
67-50 here at Wells Fargo Center. Back to wrap it up on the other side. The final. Steve Tunn's team falls to 1-3. Philadelphia with the win, now 3-1. They've beaten Cleveland twice already this year. Tanner Ottobaugh was outstanding. He's standing by with Tina.
All right, Brent, thank you. Dan, 12 for 12 in the second half. You had 4 of your 8 touchdowns then. What made the difference?
We caught some rhythm there before the end of the first half. We got two scores, and then we're able to get a quick one, so a 3-score swing there. And, you know, Coach Dalzell's all about getting off on the right foot, and we stumbled out the gate a little bit. It's my job to get us going. So, you know, get there, get in the huddle, get a little fire under their butts, and we got it going.
Darius Reynolds told me that Coach got into you guys at halftime. But you, like you said in the huddle, what were the changes that you made as far as play calls?
Coach calls a good game every game, and we just got to go out there and execute. I got all the faith in the world in my brothers in that huddle with me. I just give them one look in the eye, say, let's roll, and I know they're ready.
And then you look at your defense, a couple of interceptions. I mean, how well is this team playing right now, especially when you look at these 3 straight wins?
Yeah, we had a good one tonight. We play well off each other. When offense is rolling, defense normally makes stops and vice versa. So we got to get there, get our special teams playing a little more special. But we'll get all 3 phases rolling, and we'll be tough to stop.
Dan, thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right, Brent, back to you.
Tina, they were 15-3 last year. Again, Coach Dalzell says they're better this year.
Yeah, they might have to move up my list. I mean, with the way they came back,
pick, yo.
And really battled after being down, and Cleveland had a ton of the momentum. They battled and came back and showed a ton of fight. I mean, he was awesome in the second half, Dan Radabaez.
Arizona, Jacksonville, and then at 7:30, L.A. Kiss taking on Orlando. So three games here in week four in the Arena Football League. How about Reynolds and his numbers with the 10 catches for a buck 14 and three scores?
Physical catches. Took a huge shot. Was able to come out and finish the game. But early on, he was delivering the punishment to the secondary of the Gladiators, catching the curl route, just strong with everything in space, and then ran downhill like he was a tailback. Very physical runner, didn't shy away from any type of contact. Had an outstanding game, and he's a guy that Clint is growing to trust week in and week out, knowing that he's going to go up and sacrifice himself to make catches like that. Outstanding performance.
He had three scores, two for McDaniel, two for Kalanamoku. Sean Kalanamoku had nine catches for a buck 14. Radabaugh, though, 26 to 31 for 315 and eight. If you're Cleveland now, you're 1-3. You don't know about the health of your starting quarterback, Dennis Avrilla, who was the backup to start the year. Now you're down to your third stringer, Arvell Nelson, who showed some nice signs, but he's also your starting Jack. So what do you do if you're the Gladiators?
Well, I think they stay with Arvell. Coach Tan believes if he gets more time with Arvell, he can make him into a good quarterback and give him the time he needs to be better.
Those are the standings, and our final score is 67-50. For Sed Bonner, Tina Servacio, and our entire crew, I'm Brent Stover. Next telecast next Saturday at 9 Eastern, Portland and Arizona. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network in association with Tupelo Honey Webstream. Up next, men's lacrosse, Virginia and Georgetown. Ben Holden and Evan Washburn will call the action. So long.